FactoryTalk VantagePoint 4.0 includes a new set of types and associated web pages that are collectively referred to as the status item solution. Status items themselves are simple items that allow users to configure simple good, bad, or green, red type indicators for items that they are interested in. In this example, we're going to use VantagePoint Manager to create a set of status items, and then we'll view them in the portal. To begin with, we're going to right-click on My Enterprise, select New, and then Item. We're going to select base.common.statusItemCollection as the type we're creating. We need to give it a simple name like My Status Items, and simply click the Create button. Now, under the My Status Items object, there's a new collection called Status Items. We're going to right-click and select New Item. We can see that we could create either base.common status items or additional status item collections. The collections give us the ability to nest status items deeper and deeper in a hierarchy. In this example, we're just going to stick with the basic status item, though. We'll simply call this item1, and we need to select a status indicator. Now, the status indicator is really just a Boolean state indicator, where true is good and false is bad. We could use really any logic we want to associate with that. We could create calculated tags that compare strings or look for specific analog ranges, etc. Or in the simplest case like we're using right now, we could point directly at a discrete Boolean tag. In this case, I'm pointing at a simulated machine is running tag. So we'll go ahead and click Create. And there you have it. Our first status item is created. Now there's lots of other options with status items, but we're just kind of taking the straight line through. We'll create a second one, and just to change it up a tiny bit, we're going to point our status indicator not at a tag under a connector, but rather under the properties of an item. So if I come down here to Basic, Intermediate, Extruders, and I find Extruder 001, we're really looking at an item type in VantagePoint, and now we're going to point our status indicator at the Start command. So now that we have these items created in our model, let's take a look at how they show up in the portal. If we open our portal and we go to Reports, My Enterprise, we can see the My Status Items collection right below My Enterprise. If we click on that, we'll get a web page that brings up the status of our two items. In the web page, we can see a few different things here. We can see that each status item currently has a green state, indicating a true value. We could also see that the overall status for our collection is green. This is because this status indicator for the collection is automatically wired up to a calculated tag that uses an AND function that will effectively evaluate all of the items in the collection, and if all of them are good, the collection is good. If any one of them, or more than one, are bad, then the collection is bad. We automatically get a link to trend, which allows us to view a little bit of historical data for that status item. So if we click on that, we could see a little bit of history for our status item. Currently we're true, wasn't that long ago we were in a false state, and we could play with the time scale of our trend. We could drag additional tags on here for more context if we want. If we go back to our status items page, we could also see that there's a little info link here. And this effectively just tells us how our status item's configured. We didn't really define any description or definition, so there's not much to see here, but it's there for users to configure if they wish to. That's the basics of how you configure a set of simple status items. There's a number of more advanced options available when configuring status items. I'd encourage you to take a look at the built-in status item sample content. There you can find lots of examples just like the one we created, as well as examples of linking content to status items and creating nested status items where you might drill down from one status item to the next to get more detail. I hope you find this new functionality useful. Be sure to watch for additional videos regarding some of the more advanced configuration options you might use with status items.